We're gearing up for another reading, this time a book drive. And in banned books happen in a lot of ways. In Arizona, it's extremely obvious, but there's something happening here too. A lot of our school districts have run out of dough. They have been cut, and they can't afford the books. So we might wind up finding ourselves doing book drives for our own community, so our own young people could have these books. Okay, so I will end the poem.
I was just going to say the underground library.
Oh yeah, part of the LibroTraficante has been to develop underground libraries, and we're trying to find out how they have been doing it. But they've actually have 6 open, 2 in Arizona, several in Texas, and we're trying to open up underground libraries in other places. And that might be a goal of the LibroTraficante group. Sign the yellow sheet if you're interested in being part of that, and we'll make this larger. Okay. I'd like to end the program with these sacred texts that have both been banned, they've been read out of before. This is like killing 2 birds with 1 stone. I'm in 2 banned books. Great, you know? I am honored. So out of infinite divisions, I will say that the voices of women there's something even more insidious, because we've been silenced for so long. And so for a book like Infinite Divisions, which is an anthology of Chicana and Latina literature, to be banned, that's another form of silencing women. So I'm going to read my work from Infinite Divisions called La Llorona. When La Llorona comes to me, vulnerability turns compassion. The haunting melody of her song wanders as wounded and random as her legend through the rivers and alleyways of my existence. La Llorona, madre perdida, who searches eternally, the phantom murderess who has killed her children, the rejected mother of desgraciados, all-giving and all-loving, the all-forgiving part of my being that is negated. La mujer bendita, la mujer fuerte, la puta madre, la soldadera, la india amorosa, la mujer dolorosa. But who can understand that a woman sentences to death the child she brings into the world? La Llorona, the feminine, haunts us if we fear her, comforts us if we understand. La madre who grieves at bringing children into a world that may destroy them and will kill them. La Llorona, contradiction of life and death, who sacrificed her children to haunt the weak and comfort the giving. La mujer sagrada, the defiled woman. She makes peace with her vulnerability and draws from her strength. La diosa in every woman, out of Cantos al Sexto Sol. This is an altar of women, a woman's altar where the shy goddess speaks in voices more powerful than the laments of our mutilated histories, where one mind opens like an eye against the stairs that have tried to turn us into stone. This is an altar. Not a high pedestal or a political platform, but a foundation of the universe, a stage for our shadows to act their truths. This is an altar, unaltered by the war cries that have burdened each century with our own rude deaths. We place wreaths of sunflowers, wild poppies, and rosaries of corn upon our lips and kiss away each wounded moment that has sliced our heads in half until we have become twice as beautiful in both our passion and our rage. Who is that woman on the corner of Cesar Chavez and Soto Streets? Her battered vision has splintered her into 100 pieces. She is Coel Shauki, dismembered goddess whose shattered parts once scattered the steps of the patriarchal pyramid. We recognize her as a new totality for our connecting visions. Gather us in your arms, Coel Shauki. Make us whole again. Guadalupe is a braided hair that lies upon the head of a Guatemalan woman drinking a Pepsi in MacArthur Park. The power of life and death rests like water in her palms. The two-headed serpent of her soul holds her in 2 worlds that have split her mind into alternating waves of conflict and reconciliation. Heal us, Guadalupe. Become the bridge between the worlds that separate us from ourselves. Who is that woman on the border? She is Malina Chochitli, keeper of the power of nature, warrior mother and warrior sister, who does battle each day with the pompous winds that attack the very breath that survives inside the dreams of tired seamstresses. Gather us in your heart, Malina Chochitli. Give us courage for the battles ahead. Is that donut seen in stiletto heels with hips the size of Mother Earth, shaking to the dreams of Earth, fertile moment that gives birth to new consciousness? Dance with us, donut seen, enfold us in your red and black robes, bless the births we give to ourselves and each other. This is an altar of women, a woman's altar constructed for the goddess inside the heart of each woman and each man. Come to us, Diosa, work through us, Diosa, to heal the wounds of flesh and dreams, to plant the seeds of strength. This is an altar of women, a woman's altar, and here no woman will be sacrificed. Yeah. Yeah.